Hello YouTube, this is Keith Kevin Ken. How you doing? How you doing? I hope you're doing well. Time again for another knife of the day. And this is a brand new one. This is my very first CRKT knife. Never bought one before. And oh boy, did I have a big surprise. The knife of the day is the $40 CRKT CEO. That's right. For just $40, I bought this knife. I bought another knife too. And we'll talk about that on our next video. Want to try it out? I had been seeing this CEO on Blade HQ and stuff. Look how it just pops out. And I've been really anxious to try one out. And at $40, I said, let's go for it. The reason I was interested in it is I love gentleman folders. And I love thin knives. You know, just compact and thin. Well, the CRKT CEO is all of that. It is super thin. Super thin. And very light. And I have to tell you, it's well done. It's put together very well done. So, let's talk a little bit about it. It's a big surprise. I literally bought this. It arrived. And I have had it on my desk the whole week and a half since I've gotten it. So, you guys know I don't like flipping up knives and stuff. I'm just not comfortable with it. I know you guys do, everybody does. I'm just not that comfortable with it. This knife with the lug just flips up. You guys who can do it will flip it up all the time. You'll see me on occasion flip it up. This blade wants to go up into position with this lug. It's very well done. And one reason is it's riding on IKBS ball bearing pivot. So it is super smooth. I mean, so you can see the lug right here. It goes into this groove. See how it just popped out? The groove right here in the handle and with the liners. It's not flush at all, but it gives you a little bit. You see, it comes out a little bit like that. That's why, for me, it's a little harder to flip. But I tell you, you just give it a little flip, and it's up. And with just a little practice, which I haven't practiced, but you've seen it, it just flips up. You guys will have this thing shoot up so fast. So it's super light, super thin, but it feels substantial enough because of the liners. And I'm going to give you a quick overview, then we'll talk about the blade and everything. So it has skeletonized liners. It is a liner lock. It's super thin. And then you see the clip. It's only right hand tip down clip. Super deep carry. And it's really designed to be like a ink pen. So here's an ink pen. This is smaller than the ink pen. Okay. The width, except for the clip. But it's thinner than this ink pen. And you can just slip it into a shirt pocket. A dress shirt pocket. Where you'll just see the clip. So then you'll have your pen any place you want to go. I see how I just flipped up there. It is so nice. $40. So let's talk about this full flat ground blade. Now, why is it $40? Well, the steel is 8 CRL 13 MOV steel. It is a stainless steel. It's the steel that Spydeco uses on its value folders. Okay. So, comes super sharp, easy to sharpen, retains an edge okay. People always ask me, do I use my knives? Well, I have over 400 knives, but I have something like 20 value folders from Spyderco, and that's what does a lot of my cutting, those knives, and I love them. Now, I'm into the blade steel just like all of you guys, but 8CRL 13MOV is good enough for the price. Has a swedge on top, full flat ground, super slicey, because look how thin it is. 3.1 inch on the blade, 7.5 inches total. As I told you, ink pen, this is with it fully extended. But as you can see, with it down, small, nice package. Again, with the lug, the release is great on IKKBS ball bearings. It only weighs 2.1 ounces. It has sizable stainless steel liners, but those are skeletonized too. You see that in there to take off some of the weight. Now, these scales, I have to be honest with you. When I took it out of the box, and every time I pick it up, it feels like carbon fiber to me. Now, I'm gonna probably get comments of people going, of course it's not carbon fiber. But listen, I never say I'm super experty. This channel is about what I feel about the knives I actually buy. And we can argue about how dumb I am, depending on who you talk to about knives. But no one can argue the fact that I own and have picked up a whole lot of carbon fiber knives. Okay? Whether it's Chris Reeve, Spyderco, wherever. All right? And it feels like it. But of course, I knew it couldn't be super, super duper carbon fiber. Actually, it's not. It's glass reinforced nylon. Glass reinforced nylon. Now, FRN scales that I am familiar with from Spyderco that are in all of their lightweight knives, etc., is fiberglass reinforced nylon. So my guess is it's pretty much the same kind of structure, but it does not feel like FRN scales on this knife. They have made it so that it feels like a luxurious kind of scale. Very nice. Super nice. Actually, something that I wouldn't mind having on an outside of a ink pen. You know, it feels nice, executive, luxurious, but obviously doesn't cost that much. The base, as you can see, it's squared off. The liners are flush. I mean, not the liner, the liner lock is flush against the side. But even with my fingers, I have no problems getting to it. They did a great design thing. So there's the pocket for the lug, right? Makes it look great when you pull it out of a pocket. It looks nice, you know. And then, like I said, you get it out here, it just flips out easily. And now you have just a little bit of that so that you can use that opening. If you have any trouble with the liner lock, to hell with the liner lock. Comes down super smooth as well. You know, just as I'm talking to you, opening and closing the knife, I'm getting better and better at just hitting it with no thought. You know, it's not painful and it just flies open. This is one of the best built $40 knives that I've ever seen. I posted this on Instagram. Someone said they bought it as a steak knife. But it is that kind of knife. Because it cuts so nice, super thin. I like it. I really like it. I wish they do more variations. I saw that Blade HQ, it looked like they were going to have a new variation coming out that'll be expensive at $56. On the website, it says it's coming. Someone on Instagram said it already came and went quickly. But what a real nice knife. The knife of the day was a big surprise for me. That's why you should get out of your comfort zone every now and then. Try something else. Sometimes you fail and you get a piece of crap. In this case, I've got a knife that I really, really like. You can put it in your pocket, doesn't take up any pocket space. And again, designed really to wear as an ink pen. And with that 3.1 inch blade, the 8 CRL 13 MOV steel, you've got a knife that can really do you some good. Let's see. I figured I'd bring out the paramilitary 2 to give you a feel for the size when it's fully open. And then here's the para 3. Super thin, super light at 2.1 ounces. Feels quality through and through. Deploys great. And only $40. It's my very first CRKT. It's the CEO, and I'm so happy about it. It almost has a permanent place on my desk since it's so small. There you have it, the knife of the day. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on your notifications. More videos coming. I tried another knife from a company I hadn't heard about until a week ago. And I like that one too. Maybe I just like knives, but I like that one too. I'll show you that one later on. Also, from Spydeco, we have three variations on the Salt 2 that you'll see. And hopefully, in this week, they'll be shipping out some of the big knives that we're all waiting for. They're going to have to do that sooner or later. They only have like 2.5 months to deliver a whole bunch of knives. So my fingers are crossed that we're about ready to see a bunch of knives from Spydeco. You guys have a perfect day. Keep those pockets full. Goodbye.